Pretty cool, huh?
Oh, yeah.
And now, if any of you guys are interested in one of those, they are about $100,000 a piece, if you're really interested. So, so that's really cool. You can really see the power of those robotic arms lifting those 100-inch screens and throwing them around like they're just like paperweights. But I tell you what, this is one segment of it, and the other one, see, we have... these types of robo shows, which are kind of abstract, more artsy type, and then we actually have some that are kind of bringing out a little bit more of a lighthearted humor in them. So the next robo show I'd like to show you is called Retro Future, which Retro Future is basically as if a friend from outer space comes to visit our planet to observe the human race, but it just happened to be in the 1960s. So enjoy Retro Future, one of the quirkier versions of the robo shows. Have fun.
July 9th. Terrestrial year, 1960. Velocity, light speed, approximately. Galactic location, far, far away. Engaging light speed. No! Research Officer Number 7, reporting to Zylox Central Command. Following a 24-hour cycle on the Earth, I now report my findings on the planet's most peculiar life form and its quest for a condition called happiness. These strange and fascinating creatures are called the humans. Characteristics. They are soft, noisy, mildly hairy, and equipped with a complex system of sensors. Each human has five basic senses with which they perceive the world around them. The information gathered through these senses often triggers conditions the humans call emotions. My research shows pronounced similarities between humans and certain other species. Some suspect a genetic link. Perhaps someday humans can also evolve into an advanced species. For now, however, humans remain the humble servants of Earth's dominant life forms. Humans pair off to mate, selecting their partners through a bizarre and complicated set of ritual displays. Certain types of close physical contact, such as the exchange of saliva, activate an emotion the humans call love. Humans work hard to gain shelter and other necessities. Of particular importance to them are the moving metal containers in which they often spend many hours experiencing emotions from calm to anxiety and frustration. Humans seek food as well and will eat almost anything. To aid them in their hard work, humans engage in an activity called the coffee break. This energizing liquid is consumed by man, woman, and child alike at any hour of day or night. To distinguish themselves within their herd, humans create artificial decoration for their heads and bodies. These are bright, colorful, colorful and attractive, but not always logical. Beyond their daily needs, humans seek the highest emotional state, which they call happiness. Unfortunately, happiness is only a temporary condition, which humans must struggle to renew again and again. It can be achieved through many types of activity, including vigorous rhythmic movement and melodic vocal noises. Examination of the humans has revealed intriguing information. However, it seems that my exposure has caused a malfunction in my system. I am registering sensations of affection for the humans of Earth and sadness at leaving them. Is this what the humans call emotion? A curious phenomenon. Further investigation is required. This is serious. Xylos, Research Officer Number 7, canceling return flight to Xylos and redirecting vessel 180 degrees. Destination, Earth. Objective, happiness.
That's kind of a fun one. That's a fun one. And when you look at us as a human race from an outsider's perspective, we are really goofy creatures, aren't we? Well, I tell you what, the next thing we want to show you here, I got a couple more things to show you. One of them is actually combining both technologies, actually, of the Vistarama as well as the RoboShows. Now, our vice president of entertainment, his name is Nick Weir, and he has always had a crazy obsession with Leonardo da Vinci. Da Vinci's works has truly transcended both art as well as science. And he had this idea of a Vistarama. First of all, the Vistarama itself is of Da Vinci's works of art. And picture this, I think it's actually coming up right now. We have this big Austrian curtain, isn't it gorgeous? Every major theater in the world has a big Austrian red curtain. All right, so you can see this, well, you can't really see it now because they're on the way up. But this is the Book of Da Vinci, and it will open up, date 1492, and the book itself opens up and turns into a Vistarama. And throughout the evening, if you're just sitting in here having a cocktail or maybe you having a bite to eat, these Vistaramas will actually start creating or recreating the artwork of Da Vinci. And essentially, the idea was, well, what if Da Vinci himself lived long enough to see some of his inventions take form and take flight? So you'll be hanging out in here, just enjoying a Vistarama, and then suddenly the RoboScreens will join in, creating a really beautiful number. It's called Leonardo's Dreams. Enjoy, everyone. Leonardo's Dreams, my personal favorite. Isn't that a nice one?
That's a really nice one.
Alright, well, we're going to go ahead and actually, I'm going to leave you at this point, but I've still got a couple more things to show you if you'd like to stick around. The first one is actually going to be for the young and the young at heart. Now, earlier we showed the virtual symphony. Well, this next one we're going to show you is the ocean symphony. And it's basically if all of the little fishies would come out and play us a song. It's a lot of fun. So that's the Ocean Symphony that's coming up right now. And then after that, we're just going to show you a couple of different of the Vista rounds. And later on tonight, you can always come in and see some more as they churn through. But I'm sure many of you saw many others. But we'll show you the stained glass scene that actually goes through a number of different seasons. And that'll be just right after this Ocean Symphony. But folks, thank you very much for coming out to the 270 experience. It's quite the room, it's quite the innovation when it comes to the Anthem of the Seas. And we hope you have a wonderful day right here on board our Anthem of the Seas. So we're gonna open it up to the Ocean Symphony and you all have a wonderful, wonderful day on board. Thanks everyone.
Gracias.